Hello, and welcome to this tutorial on how to use 1,000 Books Before Kindergarten on Read Squared. 1,000 Books is a program that we have had at the library for a while, and we have just added a new format to make it easier for you to log your child's books from home. The way that you sign up for 1,000 Books is that you go to the main Read Squared website, and then you create an account so that you can track your reading from home. You can register for an account one of three ways. Either click on the register link in the upper right-hand corner, click register online here, or click register now underneath the login button. If you already have an account, go ahead and log in here. Otherwise, go ahead and click one of the registration options. You're going to be given several different ways to register. And depending on the number of children you have who you want to sign up for this program, you should pick either myself or myself and children. If you only have one child that you want to sign up, go ahead and click on myself and create an account in your child's name with your email address, obviously. Or if you have multiple children that you would like to register for this program who are not yet kindergarten aged, you can click on myself and children. That's the easiest way to get everybody set up at once. For the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to click on myself and children. So this is the adult information. So go ahead and click on your age and which program you want to sign up for. Right now, we're going to pick out 1,000 Books pre-K. For this screen, just fill out your information. You're going to fill out your name, your email address, username, password. You don't have to put your date of birth in, although you will have to put in your child's. So just go ahead and fill this one out with whatever username and password you would like to use. And now that you have all of your adult information filled out, just go ahead and click continue. Now you're going to start registering your child. You pick how old your child is and what program you want to sign them up for. We're going to say that my first child that I'm signing up is under 1 year old. We just want to get an early start on this program, and we're already reading a lot at home. And we're signing up for 1,000 Books pre-K. From here, you need to fill out a similar screen. Add your child's first and last name, date of birth, and just go ahead and use the same email address that you used to sign up. To make it very easy, don't add a username or password, because you can just access this through the main account that you made as an adult. So let's go ahead and fill this out really quickly. Okay, I've added my first reader's information. And as you can see, it should match up with what I had for my adult reader as far as the email address. So now we're gonna scroll down. If you would like to receive book recommendations, go ahead and click on yes, and send me recommendations by email. And you can tell us what sort of characters you like to read about. Does your child like animals or monsters? Do they prefer male or female perspectives? What reading level is this? You can also tell us what kinds of books you like to read and what interests you when you read. So, for some reason, my baby really loves reading about aliens. So we're going to click on that box. And they are a toddler, so 0 to 4. What kind of books either you enjoy reading to your child or your child really enjoys? So, we like fairy tales. Let's go ahead and read some fairy tales, possibly about aliens. And we really wanted to make sure to include some diverse characters. So now you can just hit continue. This is our second child, and we're just going to fill out the same information for them, how old they are and what program. So now that my information here is filled out, we're going to hit continue. And we have the same screen as the previous child. So let's fill this child's information out, and then we can move on. Okay, here is our second child. We have first name, date of birth, and the same email address that we've been using. Again, we're not going to put in a username or password because those are not required, and your 2-year-old doesn't need to log her own books, you're probably going to help her out. And we want some book recommendations as well. We really like animals for toddlers and nature. Big nature bug. Let's also look at some feeling friendship and social skills. We're done adding children for now. Okay, this is your dashboard. You can see how many books you have completed just by looking here. If you are logging books from home for your child, you need to log them individually. So we're going to log them. Today, we read But Not the Hippopotamus by Sandra Boynton. Now, this is why I wanted to show you how to do the family reading setup, because this shows that all three of you read that book. And if you did all three sit on the couch and read the book together, go ahead and keep them checked. But you probably want to uncheck the adult reader because you don't need to get points for yourself because you have already graduated from kindergarten. But if you read it to both of your kids, you can leave these open. However, if your early reader was off running around and you were just reading this to the baby, you're going to unclick them as well. So, baby reader is going to get the points for this book. Click submit. And it shows specifically which reader got the points. And it's 1 point per book. And if you wanted to review the book, you can go ahead and click here. And you can write in your book review. Again, pick which family member participated. If you only have one child and you only signed up that one child, you don't need to do the participation section. It's just going to automatically log. If you like to just sit and read a stack of books at a time, or you're a little bit busy with your under kindergarten age children and you don't want to log individual books, that's totally okay. You can send us an email and we would be happy to log batches of books for you and it'll show up on your account. The way to do this is to send an email to the email address that's going to be featured at the end of this video. There will be an end screen that has a reference email address. Go ahead and send an email there with the subject title 1000 books and we'd be happy to upload those on your behalf. If you just want to log one at a time or you like doing it to keep track of what you have and have not read, just go ahead and follow the prompts on the log reading screen. And as you can see, you have a bunch of different badges here. These will show you when you have gotten to 100 books, 200 books, etc. If you want to see what books you have read over the course of a week or the entire program, go ahead and click on Logging History. Since we're currently under the adult screen, we don't have anything on here. Because as an adult, you are not going to be able to qualify for 1,000 books before kindergarten. However, if you go up here and you click on your different children's names, you're going to be able to find the books that they have read or you read to them. So we're going to click on the baby reader and hit change. And see? But Not the Hippopotamus, the book that we just logged, is right here. And once you get to 100 books, for every 100 books, you get that badge. Normally at the library, we would give you a sticker. But if you're doing this remotely, what you do is you click on prizes. And this is not going to show anything right now because we don't have 100 books. But when it does, it'll show you what badges you have. And from there, you can print off the pages. So let's go out of here and go back to the dashboard. Especially for the digital version of the 1000 Books Before Kindergarten program, we have a separate badge that you may have noticed on this main screen. It's called 30 Things to Do Before Kindergarten. And the way to get to this badge is to go over to the left. If you click on Logging, you're going to get to a Log Activity section. You can either log your books, like we already did on the main page, or you can complete what's called a mission. And this is a supplemental activity that you can do that are just 30 fun things you can do with your child before they enter kindergarten. You can either click on this green link here, or you can click go to mission. They'll both take you to the same screen. And now this displays 30 things that you can do before kindergarten with your child. And some of them are fun things like playing with blocks. And some of them are going to help you acquire information, like visiting your local library's website, where we have lots of digital 24/7 databases, books, movies, music, all kinds of fun stuff. Once you have done each of these, just go ahead and click on the Complete Now button and hit Complete Activity. And when you do, it's going to show that you have completed it. And once you get the badge, it's going to show up in color on your main page. And see, because I X'd out of that, it shows me I have completed one out of the 30 activities and how many more activities I have in order to finish and get this badge. And finally, you remember when at the beginning of this we signed up for a reader's advisory on different recommended books? The way that you get to that information is to click on the advisory tab. So let's click on that. And we'll just hit this arrow here so that we can make sure that we know who we're getting recommendations for. We picked out book recommendations for both of the children, so baby and early reader. So let's click on baby, and you see it has baby selected. If you want to change the recommendations, just click preferences. And as you can see, we have baby selected here, and it's got the same corresponding name here. So this is what we had picked out at the beginning we were interested in. If while you are involved in this program, your child suddenly likes books about animals, go ahead and add that. Maybe they are fascinated by the bird that keeps going by the window, so we want some nature. If you are not as into fairy tales as you were when you started, just take it away. And then when you're done, at the bottom, hit Save Changes, and that will save the recommendations for the person that is specified. And to get back to the main page, you just click on Home. And this will take you to your dashboard. And finally, if you would like to check on your badge history for each of your children, you can once again go up here and you can change over to see which child has gained how many points and which badges that they have won. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial on how to do 1,000 books before kindergarten. We hope that this program is something that you and your children will enjoy and be able to do together. If you have any questions, just send us an email at the email address that's going to show up at the end of this video, and we would be happy to help you out to the best of our ability. Thank you so much, and have a wonderful day.